Okay, so in the lab manual on page 30, at least this edition, just look for the table of contents for domain of a function. It sort of reviews everything we just talked about, and then you've got some examples, and it says determine the domain of the following functions, write your answer in integral notation, and notice that all three of these are rational functions, but these last two are quadratics in the denominator. So you have to know how to factor those, okay? So before you can find the domain, the denominator cannot equal zero. But again, the way that you solve a quadratic is a lot of people want to add 15 to both sides. And that's just not going to work because there's an x squared term and there's an x term. So it's different than solving for x when you have a linear term, when you just have an x. You cannot, you always have to set it equal to zero and then factor. So if I try to factor this, remember x goes here and here, and remember what you want to do is you want to check the factors of 15. 1 times 15 and 3 times 5, those are the only two choices. And then you look at that sign. Which one of these factors subtract to be 2? And that's 3 and 5. Okay, now I want it to be a positive 2, so I want my 5 to be positive, my 3 to be negative. So that means that x minus 3 cannot equal 0. That's the next step. You set each factor not equal to 0. Or x plus 5 cannot equal to 0. So x can't be, add 3, can't be 3. And x can't be negative 5. All right, but you want it in interval notation. So remember, if you have two restrictions, it's going to show up like this on the graph, a hole here and a hole here, but there's a bunch of numbers in the domain here, and then there's some numbers in the domain here, and then there's some numbers in the domain here. So in interval notation, that would be negative infinity to negative 5, union negative 5 to 3, union 3 to infinity. So just wanted to do one more with you. You can try 3. Same thing, it's a quadratic. You got to know how to solve a quadratic equation. It has to be set equal to 0, then you factor, and you set each factor equal to 0. All right, and then this page is some practice with finding the domain, and notice that these are all radical functions. This has an index of 2. This has an index of 4, so these are even-indexed radicals. Look back at your notes. What is the rule for even-indexed radicals? And then this one is an odd-indexed radical. So what is the rule for odd-indexed radicals? Are there any? Look at the graph of that to see it, what the domain is graphically, and then go, aha, I know what the domain is. All right, so try that out, and then I have the key for you. But what I wanted to finish up this lesson with this real-world example here. Page 32, it's real-life limitations. And it's we do word problems in here, and so word problems are always have restrictions that are because real life, right? So you have to think about the real world domain. So many quantities in the real world cannot take uncertain values. For example, time can't be negative. So you might have a function that has a domain of all real numbers, but in the real world that maybe the x stands for time. And so that would mean your domain would be from 0 to infinity. Okay, can't be negative. So this says state the independent and dependent variables. I call that, write your math English dictionary, and determine the domain of the following functions, and then write your answer in interval notation. Okay, so the first step is to read the problem. It says the cost C in dollars of producing X yards of a certain fabric is given by this function. So my math English dictionary, my input X is yards of fabric. So the yards is the unit, and we're talking about yards of fabric. My output output is C of X, and that's the cost in dollars. So my units are dollars. Okay? So we have the independent and dependent variables. X is my input, and C is my output. All right, this is my independent variable. This is my dependent variable. Okay, then it says find the domain of the functions. Well, there's just two restrictions that you have to know. Is there a denominator? No. So there's no restrictions on the denominator. Is there a radical with an even index? No. So this domain would normally be all real numbers. But last question, is there a real world restriction on X? Yes. Can you have negative yards of fabric? No. So this domain is 0 to infinity. Now some people argue, can you have 0 yards of fabric? That's a good question. You have to think about it. In a real world problem, you have to think about it. And this is a cost function. So if you had 0 yards of fabric, is there a y-coordinate that makes sense? Well, if I put 0 here and here and here, all that goes away. So when x is 0, c is 1500. This is an ordered pair. This is yards and this is dollars. Is that true? Yeah, this is a cost function. When you have 0 yards of fabric, it's still going to cost you $1,500. And the reason is because maybe you're in a warehouse. You have to pay for the lights to stay on. You have to pay for the machinery. So there is a cost even if you have 0 yards. So that bracket is very necessary. Okay, let's look at the second one. It says the surface area S of a sphere, okay, so sphere like a basketball, is a function of its radius r given by S of r equals 4 pi r squared. So this is function notation. It's supposed to help you with your math English dictionary. R is my input because it's inside the parentheses, and it stands for radius. And we're not told the units, but it could be anything, meters, centimeters, inches. And my output is the surface area of the sphere. All right, and we want to know the domain. Well, you go back to what we've learned. Number one, is there a denominator? Nope. So there's no restriction there. Is there a radical, even index radical? Nope. No restriction there. So R, if this were not a real world problem, would be all real numbers. But question number three, what is R? Are there restrictions on radius? Can you have a negative radius? That's like a negative length. No, you can't have a negative radius. So this, there X, so R has to be positive. Now the question is, can R be 0? Well, if you plug 0 in, you get 0 is your surface area. I mean, you can make an argument that that's true, but that problem doesn't make any sense. So I think it's better to say 0 is not included. You have to have some sort of radius or you don't have a sphere. Doesn't exist. All right, and then this last one, the stopping distance of a car after the brakes have been applied varies directly as the square of the speed s. So in algebra 2 back in the day, you had to be able to write this function. Well, don't worry about it. I gave it to you right here. So d equals ks squared. Now read carefully. Stopping distance d varies directly as the square of the speed s. So my two variables are s and d. This k is a constant. You just treat it like a number. So the ordered pairs I'm caring about are, if I know the speed, my input, then my output will be the distance, stopping distance. Okay, so the independent variable is the speed. Okay, and my dependent variable, it would be stopping distance. The speed you travel is what's going to cause your stopping distance. All right, stopping distance depends on your speed. If you're going really, really, really fast, it's going to take you a long time to stop. All right, so the domain of this function, well, number one, is there a variable s in the denominator? Nope. Is there a variable s in a radical? Nope. So normally, this s would have a domain of all real numbers, but it's a word problem. So can speed be negative? No. Okay, so the domain is going to be 0 to infinity. Now, can you have zero speed? Can you be traveling 0 miles per hour? Well, then your stopping distance would be 0. Okay, and that's valid. So I'm going to put a bracket there. All right, and the last question is the stopping distance is the dependent variable. This is not, in my opinion, not hard, but people forget to think about it. So remember, we won't tell you this on the test. If we say what's your domain and it's a word problem, we really mean what's the real world domain. Don't forget about the third question, right? Can time be negative? Can radius be negative? Can speed be negative? And that's going to affect your domain. Okay, if this were not a word problem, all three of these problems would have a domain of all real numbers. But because it's a word problem, there's a real world restriction that you have to think about. All right, and then the last three, this tells me if you really know what you're doing, because there's a lot going on. You've got a radical in the denominator here. You have a radical in the numerator. It's not a problem that the radical is in the numerator. It's a problem that it's a radical. You have to go back and look at your notes. You have a quadratic. Can you factor that? Here you have an x times a radical. Okay, so try these and check the key and see if you can do those.